the mathematician who gave the definition of probability and what is random experiment and what are the words certain, more likely, equally likely means. And next we discussed about elementary events, mutually exclusive events, complementary events, and equally likely events. So these definitions are very, very, very important to public point of view. And they gave the question as write the definition of mutually exclusive events and give an example.
Occurrence of one event is prevented by the second event. Is called as
mutual of another event, prevents the occurrence of another event. So that is mutually occurring events. Okay, very good. Example,
Cristiano Ronaldo is a football player.
Okay, very good. He doesn't play any other game?
No, ma'am, he doesn't play any other games.
Huh?
He will not play any other games, ma'am.
Do you know that is right?
Yes, ma'am.
So here we have to give the example in which what's his name? Ronaldo. Okay. But some players are playing more than one sports or games. Okay, you have to mind it. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
So I gave an example that, for example, I am giving that Chaitanya belongs to 10th class. So here, the occurrence of your 10th class, having 10th class, prevents the occurrence of other classes. So you have to give the example which prevents the other occurrences. Okay? So that is mutually exclusive events. Very, very important concept. And next one, complementary events, elementary events. All these are very important ones. And next topic, our topic is the sample space. So what is sample space? So the set of outcomes of an experiment is called as sample space. The set of outcomes of an experiment is called as sample space. Like, what are our experiments? Tossing a coin, rolling a die, okay? And next, picking a card from the deck of cards. All these are our experiments, okay? So, the set of outcomes of an experiment is called as sample space. So, what is the set of outcomes when a coin is tossed? What are our set of outcomes?
Heads, tail.
Very good. Heads and tails. Okay, heads and tails. So, if we toss a coin, we may get the heads or tails. Okay, this is our outcomes, possible outcomes of an experiment. And the set of these outcomes is called as a sample space. Okay, and another example. If we have interest to give another example, when a die is rolled, what are the possible outcomes? What are the set of outcomes? So, set of
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Okay, so all two are certain events. What does it mean? Certain means
the thing which will definitely happen.
So we can say that the event which is certain to happen is called as certain event. Certain, another name for this one is sure event. Okay, so the event which is exactly will occur is called as a certain event. The event which is certain to happen is called as a certain event. Example, give an example. So what is the event that should compulsorily be happen?
Get a hot sunny day in a summer season.
Very good. Hot sunny day in a summer season. Okay. And next. And
melting of ice cream in
hot season or in summer. Getting heads or tails when a coin is tossed. When a coin is tossed. Okay. Getting a card when we pick up a card from deck of cards. Okay. So all these are sure events. Getting heads and tails or tails when a coin is tossed. That means if we toss a coin, we have get any one of these two, heads or tails. So this is our sure event. And next one, impossible event. Next one, impossible event. So what is impossible event? The event. The event which is not possible. The event which is not possible. That means it doesn't occur. It doesn't occur. It is not possible to happen. To happen is called impossible event. So it is nothing but impossible event. Okay. And what can we give the example as? Example. Give an example for impossible event.
Melting of ice cream when ice cream is in deep refrigerator.
Deep refrigerator. And sun rises in the west. Okay. Sun rises, not goes. Rises. Not sets. Rises. So it is one of the examples. Sun generally rises in which east direction?
East
direction. But we gave the example as sun rises in the west.
West.
It is impossible. Impossible event. And in our experiments, we can give getting seven when a die rolled. When a die rolled. Okay. And that means if we roll a die and getting seven, it is not possible because die has only six faces and six numbers. Okay. So it is impossible even. Okay. Write down in your CW. If completed, inform me. I will rub the board.
Number of favorable outcomes by total number of outcomes.
Okay. Is equal P of E. It is denoted by P of E. P of E means probability of an event. So that is equal to number of favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes. By number of total outcomes. Total possible outcomes. So this is our formula. Only one formula. Okay. So, but here the concept is depth. So you have to understand the subject and concepts also. Okay. So what is elementary events? What is elementary event? Anyone?
An event having only one outcome.
Very good. An event having only one outcome is called as elementary event. So I am asking questions like this one. So our event is our event. Event means that we favored, that we want. That is nothing but event. So our event is I am tossing a coin, getting heads. What is the probability here?
1/2.
Probability of event. So what is event? You have to first identify the event. What is our event? Getting heads when we toss a coin. So how many number of favorable outcomes here? When we toss a coin, we have only one favorable outcome to get a heads. So 1/2. Total number of possible outcomes are
2.
Because total number of possible outcomes means we may get heads or tails, our sample space. So what is our sample space? H, T. So how many elements are there? 1, 2. So our total possible outcomes are 2. And what is our event? Getting heads. Okay. So here, getting heads means if we once toss the coin, there is only one possible outcome, one favorable outcome, and total number of possible outcomes are 2. So the probability here is 1/2. And next, getting tails. Getting tails. This is our event. And again, we have to find the probability of the event. How many favorable outcomes?
1.
1 by total possible outcomes are
2.
So 1/2. Here the favorable outcomes is 1. And here also the favorable outcomes is 1. Okay. So can we say that these two are elementary events?
Ma'am?
Can we say that these two are elementary events?
No, ma'am.
Yes, yes. Can we say that these two are elementary events? Yes, we can say these two are elementary events because the favorable outcomes are 1. Here also 1. So these two are elementary events. What is elementary event?
An event having only
one outcome. Here also only one outcome. And here also one favorable outcome. So these two are elementary events. Okay.
Ma'am, are possible outcomes two unnai kada, ma'am?
We are not saying about possible outcomes. Just we are saying about favorable outcomes. If favorable outcomes are 1, then we say them as elementary outcomes. Elementary events. So, I am adding these two elementary events. So, 1/2 + 1/2. So, here 2 is LCM. So we get our numerator as 1 + 1, that is equal to 2/2. So what we get?
1.
That means the sum of elementary events is equal to 1. The sum of elementary events in a experiment is equal to 1. Okay. And this is one of the important notes. The sum of elementary events is 1. And next, it can also be called as the total probability. So the total probability of an experiment is equal to how much?
1.
Okay, it is also 1. Okay, that means these two events are elementary events. If we add these two, then we get total probability as 1. In the same way, if we roll a die, then what is the chances of getting 1 on top face? What is the chances of getting 1 on top face?
1/6. 1 chance.
1/6. So, if we roll a die, so event here is getting 1. Die vesinappudu 1 vache probability entha ani adugutunnam. Getting 1. So our probability formula is favorable outcome by total outcomes. So favorable outcome is 1 by total outcomes are 6. So 1/6. And next, getting 2. This is also 1/6. Having one chance only by total outcomes are 6, 1 by 6. In the same way, getting 3, P of E is equal to 1 by 6. And next, 4, P of E is equal to 1 by 6. P of E is equal to getting 5, 1 by 6. And 6, P of E is equal to 1 by 6. That means if we roll a die, we may get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. So what is the probability here? 1 may have 1 chance, 2 may have 1 chance, 3 may have 1 chance, 4 may have 1 chance, 5 may have 1 chance, and 6 may have 1 chance. So probability of getting 1 is 1 by 6, 2 is 1 by 6, 3 is 1 by 6, 4 is 1 by 6, 5 is 1 by 6, and 6 is 1 by 6. All these are
added.
Which type of events? Elementary events. Elementary events. And if we add all these 1 by 6 plus 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 1 by 6. Here the denominator is LCM is 6 and 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. That is equal to 6 by 6. That is equal to 1. So the total probability here also is equal to 1. And the sum of elementary events is equal to 1. Okay? Write down in CW. Is less than the if the numerator is less than the denominator, then we call it as proper fraction. So all probability fractions are proper fractions only. So we cannot get improper fraction. That is one of the important note here. So another important note is probability is find the probability of getting one comma, two comma, three comma, four comma, five comma, six. When a die is rolled. So Chaitanya, tell me the answer. What is the probability of getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 when a die is rolled?
6 by 6, 1, ma'am.
6 by 6. So here probability of event. So event, what is our event? When a die is rolled, getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Any one of those. So this is which type of event? Probability of sure event or certain event is equal to 1. This is very important bit. Probability of sure or certain event is equal to 1. Because probable outcomes and total outcomes are equal. And next one, probability of getting 7 when a die is rolled. What type of event is this?
Impossible event.
So impossible event. So favorable outcomes are when a die is rolled, getting 7 is the impossible event. Favorable outcomes? How many outcomes?
Zero. Zero, ma'am.
Zero. By total outcomes are 6.
7.
So that is equal to 0. So the probability of an impossible event is equal to 0. So probability of impossible event is equal to 0. So probability of impossible event is equal to 0. So by seeing all these probabilities, we can say that probability is a proper fraction. That means less than 1. That means probability lies between 0 and 1 and equals to 0 and equals to 1. So from this we can say that 0 less than or equal to P of E, that means probability of an event, is less than or equal to 1. So this is very, very important point of view. 0 less than or equal to P of E less than or equal to 1. These are all important bits. The probability always proper fraction. And next, the probability of sure event is equal to 1. And probability of impossible event is equal to 0. And probability always lies between 0 and 1. 0 less than or equal to P of E less than or equal to 1. All these are important bits. Okay, write down NCW. Tails, when a coin is tossed, it is our event. So what is our event? Getting tails by tossing a coin. So what is the complementary event to that one? Not getting tails. So our event is getting tails. Our event is getting tails. So not event, that means complementary event. So what is complementary event? Not favorable to that event. So not getting tails. So there are only two possibles, that is tails and heads. Okay. So getting tails probability is 1/2. Getting tails probability is 1/2. And not getting tails probability is also 1/2. Because there are only two possible outcomes, that is getting tails and getting heads. Here not getting tails means getting heads only. Okay. So here I am giving another example, that is our event is getting prime number when a die is rolled. So what is our probability here? What is our probability getting prime number when a die is rolled? What is our probability?
3/6, ma'am, is equal to 1/2.
So what are the possible outcomes? What are our sample space, first of all? We have to find the sample space, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is sample space. And what is our favorable outcomes? What are prime numbers here? 1 is prime number? Is 1 is prime number?
No.
So our first prime number is 2. And next prime number is 3. And next one is 5. So what is our event? Getting prime numbers when a die is rolled. So here prime numbers are 2, 3, 5. So our probability is P of E is equal to favorable outcomes are 3 divided by total outcomes are 6. So 3/6.